just after we spoke to you guys last week, Ben Fordham and 2GB broke this story about the climate hypocrisy of Anthony Albanese and Chris Bowen. I've got to show that. Now, the two jets, 20 minutes apart, both going from Canberra to Scone in the Hunter Valley. I mean, Mark, we see so many examples of climate hypocrisy, virtue signalling hypocrisy, but this one's a standout.
It's almost ridiculous. Bowen threw the RAF under the bus as well in another classic Labor move, which is to throw someone else under the bus. But a lot of people much wiser than me have got many takes on this. Yes, it's hypocritical and it's a waste of taxpayer money. But it sort of tells me two things about Chris Bowen, is that not even Anthony Albanese will spend an hour with him on a flight. And let him on board. He's that bad a bloke. He must stink. And two, like, the general public just don't think he's cool enough to be flying private. Flying private is for rock stars. It's for Taylor Swift and, you know, the big names. It's not for people like Chris Bowen. We'll almost happily do it, but it's a waste of that sort of luxurious lifestyle on Chris Bowen, the mug. It doesn't make sense. That's what makes us really angry.
It's not a bad theory, Tim, that they needed the second jet so that Albo didn't have to listen to Bowen.
Yeah, well, you know, my theory of Monday's column about Albo being the nice guy everyone likes, that's sort of blown out the window, isn't it? But it is fascinating to me that one of the reasons that Bowen gave for having to use two jets was they had too many staffers, too many advisors, too many people from their offices to fit in one jet. Now, if you've got so many advisors that you need two jets to carry them just, you know, up the road, really, to make this announcement, if you've got all those high-powered, brilliantly well-paid, genius staffers, and not one of them suggested at any time, you know, guys, flying two jets to a climate announcement might be a really dumb idea. Not one of them. They should all be fired, and then they can fit in a Tarago.
Yeah. I think they have quantity in advisors and not quality. Hey, Tim, I want to share something that you picked up today. This is a beautiful get on social media. Jonathan Green, the former ABC opinionista, he was tweeting about showing a picture of a protester in Melbourne. He says a dude has wandered out and has halted the tram. Two cops have had a chat and walked away. 100 or so of us are stuck inside. The bloke's a Palestine protester. And someone else on Twitter tweets back and says to Green that it's a minor inconvenience compared to a genocide, time we all woke up. And Green says causing one may well have no material effect on ending the other. But yeah, so suddenly Green doesn't like the protesters because they inconvenience him on the tram.
Yes, it's always the way with our lefty friends, isn't it? In theory, things like Extinction Rebellion protests and Just Stop Oil protests that block streets, that's all fine until you're the one being blocked. Then it's personal. And, you know, Green's got a bit of background with this. He used to be the editor of Mianjin. Its real title, I think, is Brisbane. But when he edited that magazine, he would publish things saying, oh, you know, Extinction Rebellion's great. You know, these protests, they're a valid form of democratic activity. And then, of course, your tram gets blocked by a dickhead with a flag.
and suddenly Jonathan Green realises that actually the protester might not change the world as well.